Good morning, student. We are going to continue the same chapter, that is Struggle for Equality from Political Science book.
Tawa Matsya Sangh. When dams are built or forest areas declared sanctuaries for animals, thousands of people are displaced. Whole villages are uprooted and people are forced to go and build new homes, start new lives elsewhere. Most of these people are poor. In urban areas too, bastis in which poor people live are often uprooted. Some of them are relocated to areas outside the city. They work their work as well as their areas outside the city. Their work as well as their children's schooling is severely disrupted because of the distance from the outskirts of the city to these locations. This displacement of people and communities is a problem that has become quite widespread in our people usually come together to fight against this. There are several organizations across the country fighting for the rights of the displaced. In this chapter, we will read about the Tawa Matsya Sangh, a federation of fisher workers cooperative, an organization fighting for the rights of the displaced forest dwellers of the Satpura forest in Madhya Pradesh.
Originating in the Mahadev Hills of Chindwara district, the Tawa flows through Betul before joining the Narmada in Hoshangabad. The Tawa Dam began to be built in 1958 and was completed in 1978.
So this example, Tawa Matsya Sangh, this example focuses on one of the case study, that is Tawa Matsya Sangh. So Matsya means fishery and Tawa is one of the important tributary of which river? One of the important tributary of Narmada river, which flows through Madhya Pradesh. It's joined Narmada. So this Tawa River joins Narmada at Hoshangabad. It flows through Chilwara district and its originate place is where it originate?
Mahadev Hills.
Yeah, great. So it originate in Mahadev Hills.
Okay, good.
Yes, ma'am.
Continue reading further. Okay, continue reading further.
The Tawa Dam began to be built in 1958 and was completed in 1978. It submerged large areas of forest and agricultural land. The forest dwellers were left with nothing. Some of the displaced people settled around the reservoir and apart from their meager farms found a livelihood in fishing. They earned very little.
Okay, stop it. Yes, what do you understand by this? For what purpose is the dam built? So it means, we were reading this and a dam is built for what purpose? It is built to collect the extra water that is stored in that is overflowing from the river. So what we get now is a reservoir, that means where the extra water gets collected. Now, when this dam was built in 1958, the people living in nearby areas were asked to relocate. They were asked to go somewhere else to find a living because that place was needed to build the dam. Later, in 1978, when the dam was built and the people came back to settle there, what did they find? That they earned very little. They led a very hard life now because the livelihood that they could get from the fishing in that reservoir was very, very less. So now what happened? The people were in distress and let's see what happened further. Okay, I want somebody else to read from 1994.
In 1994, the government gave the rights for fishing in the Tawa Reservoir to private contractors. These contractors drove the local people away and got cheap labor from outside. The contractors began to threaten the villagers who did not want to leave by bringing in hoodlums. The villagers stood united and decided that it was time to set up an organization and do something to protect their rights.
All right. So have you understood what happened? What went wrong here? When something went wrong, when government actually gave the fishing rights to some private contractors instead of the local people. And when these private contractors came there to fish, they started driving away the local people, and as a result the local people could not get enough money and their condition became worse. So now they decided that they have to stand up united and get their rights back. So what did they do? They founded the Tawa Matsya Sangha. Okay, Tawa, as ma'am said, is the name of the river. Matsya is the fishermen or the people who do fishing, and Sangha is the organization. Now, what did they do? Let's see, how did they show their protest? Because they were unhappy with the government decision to give that fishing rights to private contractors. Yes, I want somebody else to read now.
The newly formed Tawa Matsya Sangha, TMS, organized rallies and chakka jam, road blockade, demanding their right to continue fishing for their for their livelihood. In response to their protests, the government created a committee to assess the issue. The committee recommended that fishing rights be granted to the villagers for livelihood. In 1996, the Madhya Pradesh government decided to give to the people displaced by Tawa Dam by the fishing rights for the reservoir. A 5-year lease agreement was signed 2 months later on January 2, 1997. People from 33 villages of Tawa started new year with first catch.
All right. So what happened when the people stood up in an organized manner to fight against the unequal treatment given to them? Okay, they got for them something good in return. A united effort always brings positive impact. And what did they, after employing methods like chakka jam or rallies, that is road blockade and rallies or protest, what happened was the government took notice of their protests and decided to see what is wrong actually. And then they found out that the actual problem was these people were displaced. These people were asked to go from their locality somewhere else when the dam was constructed. And as a result, they had lost their right to livelihood. Okay. And when later the government gave it to private contractors, it further created a problem for them. When the government found that the fishermen are at correct position, their problem was solved when 2 months later they could actually go and catch their first set of fish in new year, that is 1997.
Yes. The Indian Constitution as a live living document. Yes, who want to read?
Yes, ma'am. The Indian Constitution as a living document, the foundation of all movements for justice and the inspiration for all the poetry and songs on in equality, is the recognition that all people are equal. As you know, the Indian Constitution recognized that equality of all persons. Movement and struggles for equality in India constituently refer to the
slowly,
Indian
Constitution. Slowly.
Yes, ma'am. Constitution to make that point about equality and justice for all. The Fisher Works in Tawa Matsya Sangha hope that the provision of the Constitution will become a really through their participation in movements. By constantly referring to the Constitution, they use it as a living document. Something that has real meaning in our lives. In a democracy, there are always communities and individuals trying to expand the idea of democracy and push for greater recognition of equality on existing as well as new issues.
Yeah. This much is done for the day. Okay, so what does mean living document? Living document means it is something that has real meaning in our lives. What does the Indian Constitution recognize? What does it state? What do you think? Many a time we have learned this. We heard this.
And the Indian Constitution is for equality, no?
Yes. So, what does the Indian Constitution recognize?
All people are equal.
So it states that no person can be discriminated against because of his religion, because of his caste, sex, or whatever. He is rich or poor. All adult in India has the equal right to vote during election. So this power over the ballot box has been used by people to elect or replace their representative. Issues of equality are centered to the democracy. Indian Constitution recognizes the equality of all. Constitution helps people in their struggle for equality through law and through government scheme. Every person is equal before law. So no one is discriminated. Untouchability is abolished. Okay, so the Indian Constitution as a living document. It is something that has real meaning in our lives. It support or it recognizes the equality and it support through laws and through government schemes. Okay, then we'll stop here.
If you like our videos, do share them and subscribe to our channel. If you want awesome quizzes, write to us. Keep watching and keep learning with Walnut.